guys a video today on digging an inside bend. We just got it right tightened up here. It's pretty similar to plugging out, actually. See, they got as close as they can to the pipe here. Digging. It's really similar to plugging out. This ground is hard. It's a little bit of frost, but it's really hard. We've been digging here today for 2 hours and I've only got 6 joints. So only 20 minutes. You can see I threw all my dirt back, same as you would for plugging out, because you're stacking your dirt on dirt. Give yourself some room when you get to the bend. And this whole bend is going to come in straight this way. You got to visualize that. This is welded all solid, both 90s, and that'll just go straight in from the 90. Visualize how that same distance I am on the main line, I want to keep that all the way around through this bend. It'll have a little bit more slope because I'm sloping it a little bit more here. So if I go like right to the edge where my tracks were, it should be pretty close. Ditch say a foot away, and then as I slope it down it should be pretty close. I'm gonna go wider on my way out of it. Guys are driving on ditch line here again. It almost had this rip. Make sure you get out far enough on a PI too, so it'll fit. You can have the straightest ditch, but if you cut this too quick, it won't fit because it's not back far enough. If you struggle with digging straight, I'd suggest flaring out at your last set before you come out. Go a little wider just to ensure that you have enough room.
this these two 90s being dug or welded solid. Gotta visualize this whole thing going that way. So that sag and overbend there, I had to dig about 3 meters into that hill. So that makes things difficult. But yeah, you just really gotta visualize.
Colder, this would be way harder. We've been about minus 10 Celsius at night. It's been driven on for about a week. Other than that, there isn't any frost anywhere really yet. Other than where the snow and topsoil's off and it's been driven on. I'm going to leave about a meter for my stairs. Going this way 3 meters, but this way only two. That's why visualization is huge when digging. Centerline stakes at 3 meters away from the pipe all the way through here, but because it was so tight in that section, I squeezed towards the pipe more to give me more room so I wasn't throwing my clay over the topsoil. sitting on center, I'll just go as wide as my tracks and off the ditch. Maybe a hair wider. I want to dig this a little wider and make sure it fits. For depth. For heard of guys having shallow ditch and then the inspector makes them redig it. Unfortunate enough, I haven't had to redig anything for that. Visualize this pipe coming in right on the angle of those skids, straight in. Tracks as a guide. My tracks are parallel with the pipe and much guaranteed to be going straight. Dig a cellar because when they weld it, the pipe can get pushed back into that corner. here. It's good.
and it's almost gonna chomp it, but if I can still get a full scoop, I'll just dig it. Bottom is as wide as the inside of my track, so I'll make a line that's kind of a visualize a line right to the inside of my tracks to stay parallel. This line right here is starting to come in. If I bring that in too hard, that makes all that bend that I dug back there useless. The pipe won't even fit back there. So you want to stay nice and parallel with that pipe. Yeah, I create a line from there right to the inside of my trap.
be all right, I think.
All right, buddy.